Hey, Luke, is there one thing that stands out above all else tonight with Ingram with a chance to win or that weird play at the free throw line late? What do you think most about this game?
I love the way our guys competed defensively. You know, we set a challenge to them that, you know, let's be aggressive, but be smart. We want high hands. The Warriors are struggling with turnovers so far this year. So we wanted to, you know, use that to our advantage and get some stops and be able to get out and run, not let them set their half-court defense. Because when that half-court defense gets set and they're doing that switching and they got Draymond and Andre, it's tough to score because they're the best in the world for a reason. So we wanted to, you know, we set a challenge to our players tonight, and I thought they did a great job of responding to that. Couple little mistakes here and there, communication errors, switching, cost us when we had a lead down the stretch. But overall, really happy with the way that they came out and battled tonight.
What do you think what you saw from Ingram tonight, which is a continuation of some of what he's done this season, but what do you think he can really take moving forward, and how important could that be for him?
Well, I think there was a lot of learning learning moments out there for Brandon, for Zoe, for our team, as how we want to play as a team. For Brandon, the confidence in himself and to be able to go against, you know, KD's not only one of the best offensive players in the league, he's really tough to score on, and Brandon was up for the challenge. He made some tough shots. But then I think to see what it's like and to play, I mean, Brandon was locked in all day today. You saw that shoot around. So I think that's good for him. And it's not like, okay, all of a sudden I felt that and I'll be like that every day now. That's part of growth and getting older in this league. But I thought it was nice for him to have a day where all day long he was focused, he was locked in, he came out and obviously had a great game. So, he'll be able to take a lot from tonight and then slowly absorb that and just keep getting better as a player.
What went into the decision to call the timeout there when Randall had the potential play in transition? I know that at times in the past you've let them go, and what was the decision?
Yeah, I was debating that, and once the ball kind of was loose and I looked, it was 4 point, maybe 5 seconds left. I just wanted to make sure that we got a good shot up. And you know, I liked the, you know, Brandon was hot. He got to his right hand. He got a good look. I think it was Draymond or maybe Jordan Bell came over and contested it late. But it's a feel thing. And right then, normally I would like to let that play go and let the players kind of use the momentum to try to get something. But it just looked a little too chaotic as we were grabbing the rebound and you know, Julius had it. And I wanted to make sure we got a good look up.
Going to Ingram, I mean, make or miss. I mean, to have that opportunity, how important is it to have that opportunity, to take that winning shot, miss or win, make it or miss?
It's very important. It's what every it's how you get. It's how you get better. It's how you become great. It bothers you when you go home at night and then you come back to the gym and work on it. I mean, it's whatever cliche, but they make commercials about it. How do you succeed? By failing. Kobe's air balls early in his career. Jordan makes, all those type of things. So I'm not saying B.I. is Kobe and Jordan, but that's the reality of how you get better is – You try and you fail and it hurts and you get your butt back in the gym, and next time you hopefully make it, and if not, then you work even harder and eventually you start hitting those things.
Yeah, midway through the third quarter, Lonzo had turned down a couple of threes, then he made one and ran down the court. You kind of nodded at him, and that seemed to get him started. Is it just his confidence in taking that shot?
Well, he's been shooting the lights out in practice the last week or so. And I told him before the game, I said, Zoe, you're going to be one of the best point guards in this league. You are. So embrace this challenge. If you're open and it's in rhythm, and I thought most of them tonight were in rhythm. He had one, maybe two, where they went under and he hadn't dribbled and he just shot it. Those are ones we don't want. But any other three, if it's in rhythm and he's got a bounce to it, let it fly. you know, and you know, when I think when he saw the first, that one go in, it built some confidence. But those are shots we want him taking. We need him taking. And he was nice to see, you know, obviously multiple threes go in for him in a game. But he's been shooting like that and putting the work in after practice. So it didn't surprise me. I was happy for him.